Welcome to this film screening organised by the Centre of Taiwan Studies together with Formosa Salon. Tonight we have a very, very special guest, the film's producer Tsai Tsung-Lung from Zhongzheng University in Jiangyi. I've wanted to invite Tsai Tsung-Lung to SOAS for a long time. He's an award-winning documentary maker, and he makes films that look at the dark side of Taiwan, about Taiwanese that have fallen through the net in Taiwan's economic miracle. I first became aware of his work when I was researching migration to and from Taiwan. He's looked at overseas brides in Taiwan in his films. He's looked at industrial poisoning. And one of the films, he's also going to be showing a film tomorrow at Surrey on migration to and from Taiwan. So if you do enjoy this film, I also would encourage you to take the chance to watch the film in Surrey. Another thing I think is really special about tonight is this is a co-organised event. It's the first time that we've worked together with Formosa Salon. In many ways, we couldn't have put this event together without this group. When I first heard that Tsai Tsung-Lung was going to be in London, I didn't think we would actually be able to bring him to SOAS. But one of the Formosa Salon team, Xie Haitang, met him, interviewed him in Taipei, and in a matter of minutes we set up this session, which really shows you how efficient this group of idealistic students are. One of the things that we've been trying to do at SOAS over the last couple of years is to look at social movements in Taiwan. In the summer we ran a conference on Taiwanese social movements, and we ran a round table, I think in this room, on the sunflower movement. So I was really delighted that we could actually continue this theme by having the first European screening of this film. We put this event together in very, very short notice, I think only a few weeks. I hope you can understand that we don't have an ideal cinema setting, but this was the best we could do in just a few weeks. But I think that the film is so special that I think it's worth it. What we're going to do next, I'm going to let the Formosa Salon, they're going to tell you a little bit about their project, and after that, Director Tsai will talk a little bit about the film. We'll also have a reception afterwards, so don't kind of rush off. We'll take you up to the reception at the end. And we'll also have time for a Q&A as well. So over to you, Yichun.
Hi, thank you all for coming. And on behalf of Formosa Salon, I would like to thank especially Dr. Duffy Phil from the SOAS Taiwanese Study Center and for co-hosting this event and providing this fantastic venue in just a few weeks. And the other thing I want to thank is the University of Surrey and Xie Haitang, one of our members in Taiwan, who actually invited Director Tsai here. So I think it's a fantastic opportunity to kind of review and reflect on the sunflower movement and see where it leads to. And I think that's something we can really think about. And lastly, a special thanks to all the volunteers from Formosa Salon to help out to make this happen. And Formosa Salon is actually a group of mostly students dedicated to engage Taiwanese people in London to kind of discuss the public issues in Taiwan. And we organize talks and workshops regularly to discuss the public issues in Taiwan. And the members of Formosa Salon actually come from all kind of backgrounds. So you get the viewpoints from like diverse backgrounds. So if you're interested, you're welcome to join. And we will have a workshop on regeneration issues in Taiwan this Friday on the 21st. It will be in UCL from 6:30 to 9:30. And more details will be on the flyers on the desk. Some of you might have it. And if you want more information, you are welcome to check us out on Facebook, and like, there will be more information. Just enjoy the film, and if you have any questions, you can approach me and ask me. Thank you.
Or do you want it? Okay, so here's our producer, Tsai Tsung-Lung.
Yeah!
Hi, everybody. Everybody. I'm very happy that I'm very happy that I'm very happy that I'm very 我要抱歉一下就是我11年前来过诺维奇那边念书可是已经太久了所以我把英文都还给老师了所以要求必须要用英文跟大家沟通那对我来讲比较简单所以我就请那个老师帮忙翻译一下那你要不要帮我翻译一下
It's great to see you guys, and it's actually a great turnout, and he's very pleased. And of course, he felt he's more expressive and can be more articulate if he's talk about the film in Chinese. So there you go. So I'm the one you have to tolerate.
然后因为我前天我才从台湾来到Surrey那边，然后今天到伦敦这边来。 那我觉得我还在那个 jet lag 当中，所以到晚上的时候我好像就是讲话就开始结巴这样，所以如果说那个有些东西也许会反应比较慢，所以等一下片子结束以后就麻烦大家就是有问题就尽量提问，就是这样可以刺激我的神经，会有比较好的反应，谢谢。
I have just landed here, so you know, I arrived 2 days ago, and so I'm still suffering from jet lag. You can imagine that I'm a little bit not with it. However, he hoped that whatever question you raise can stimulate his brain, and later he will try to answer your questions.
然后因为我们片子有2个小时，所以我 简单报告2点就好，然后我们就来看片。那第一点就是，首先要跟各位朋友讲，就是说，可能看这部片的时候比较期待说这是一个很完整的一个史诗作品，它基本上是太阳花运动里面过程里面，我们纪录片工作者做了决定，然后在那个时候开始。 做的一个纪录片，所以它整个片子的话，它虽然只有2个小时，可是其实它有9个主题，9个短片，然后有长有短，长度并不见得是一样的，然后中间有一些断裂，或者有一些画面也许大家会觉得有点重复，因为我们有9个导演同时在做不同的主题，然后把它组合起来。 所以，第一个要强调的就是说，可能大家等一下看的那个有个心理准备，就是说，这不是一个太阳花运动的史诗作品，它可能就是，如果你期待是一个很完整的，然后看了这个片就了解整个太阳花运动的话，那可能不要抱这样的期待会比较好。
Before we see the film, I would like to draw your attention. That please do not expect to see a complete picture of this particular movement. It is not their intention because originally the decision to make the film was in the process of the movement. So it's not something that they have long-term planning. And also, there are 9 different themes, which difference in length. So it's in total, that is about almost 120 minutes. It's 119 and a bit minutes. So it's 2 hours of film. And please bear with them, because sometimes 9 different people working together, they are actually filming the same movement. So sometimes you might see something overlap or repeating themselves or in some way, but actually they have different themes. And if there's any ruptures or some repetitiveness, or you need to bear that in mind, it's 9 different people's work combined together. So it's not a complete work, or not an epic, as he rightly said.
Okay. 还有一点要强调的是说，这我们这个九个主题它比较像是九块拼图，或者是太阳运动的太阳运动的9个面向，那我们希望说透过这个片，然后来让大家了解太阳化运动的大致的面貌，那可是很重要一点就是说。 没有期待透过这个片对太阳化运动做什么样的结论，或者说，好像下一个，好像是一个判决书一样，就是说，看了这个片就会有一个定论，就是说太阳化运动就是怎么样怎么样，我们比较希望说，透过这个片子，它可以促成就是大家对台湾的太阳化运动，有更多的了解，然后更多的对话，我希望我们的这个纪录片是一个。 可以促进理性思辨的一个影像的平台，这样，这个是我们最大的期待，所以我才期待说，这个会后的讨论是很重要的，就是大家看了以后有什么样的意见就请大家尽量，不要客气，因为有想不同的立场或不同的意识形态，对这个片子就会有不同的意见出来，就欢迎大家尽量表达，谢谢。
Short films are actually like 3 pieces of jigsaws. So it is up to you to put them together. It's not something they want to draw the conclusion for you. It is actually not their intention to give a verdict of this particular movement. It is your decision. And what they wanted to do is to improve the understanding, or at least provide you some sort of opportunity to look at this particular movement through their visual representation, and providing some sort of dialogue that you can actually have the platform to negotiate and understand. So for him, the Q&A is the most important bit of tonight's event, because he said, do not hold back, just tell me what you think. And even you don't agree, you're welcome we can have a rational debate and discussion. Yeah.
好，那我们开始吧。
Okay.
I'm sure you have a lot of questions, but let me first, there's one thing I've really been dying to ask here. Could you say a little bit about, firstly about how the film was funded, and also about how you kind of brought all the various parts together, because there's 12 directors involved. Could you say a little bit about how you brought it all together?
这个片子应该大家看得出来是一个有点庞大的工程。那钱哪里来的？其实我们在开始决定要做这个。 骗子的时候啊，我们不知道钱可以从哪里来。坦白讲是这样，因为我们大概是在太阳花运动的，大概第三天第四天吧，就是行政院占领事件的那一天，行政院占领事件是三二三，大概那应该是第五天左右，就是。 因为行政院占领事件发生的时候，我人在嘉义。事实上，我一直在嘉义啊，嘉义是在台湾的南部嘛，因为这里有外国朋友。 那其实离台北非常的遥远。那因为我在那边工作，哦，可是我一直很关注这件事，然后就每天在那边看电视这样。哎，那当时有一个感觉就是说，因为我以前是当过记者，哦，我有一个感觉说台湾发生一个很重大的历史事件了，然后这个是野百合来最大的学生运动这样。哎，然后我就觉得说应该要有一些影像记录。那尤其是那个行政院流血事件之后，我就更焦虑，哦，这个东西如果没有记录的话，以后大概没有人会知道到底是怎么一回事，然后那些被打的人是白白被打了，哦，所以那时候就开始跟纪录片工会的朋友就是发起，觉得应该要开始至少要做轮班的记录，不然之前我们是各自分担各拍各的这样，哦，所以大概就是从三二四之后我们开始做组织，哦，就是有轮班的记录，然后也开始去收集有些民众他们拍的一些影像记录，开始准备，觉得未来应该可以做一个纪录片，哦，可以先这样，帮我讲太多。
As you can tell, that it's a massive, major construction, combining so many different people and different clips. He said, it's okay. In terms of funding, to be honest.They didn't know where at the beginning, they didn't know where the money will come from. However, they just felt it is a necessity to make a record of such a major incident. So it was, although he was, from the very beginning, he was in Jiayi, that was in south of Taiwan or south, middle of Taiwan. But he kept his eye on the whole process. He felt, because he was a journalist before he became an academic, he felt it's such an important incident. This is the most important student at that time. The understanding of it is a most important student movement since the Wai Lily student movement. And it is worth the while and he felt someone should do the visual recording about it. He's anxious because especially after students attempt to take over Executive Yuan and being evicted violently, and he felt if there's no proper record, it will be a waste of their blood shed. So he contacted the documentary union and they have this understanding of taking turns because not everyone has the ability to be there 24 hours, so everyone's taking turns and also as much as they could to make some sort of record, but at the same time collecting some sort of videos or film clips from the public.
基本上台湾的纪录片工作者像我一样，就是大家可能会关注一些社会议题，可是大家基本上都是单打独斗，各拍各的这样。那然后就说这个太阳花运动其实对很多人产生影响，那对我们拍纪录片的产生影响就是说，我们第一次觉得说也许可以我们也组织起来，然后对这个历史事件做一个集体的记录或集体的创作，那之前的话可能是比较不会这样想，哦，那当然这个东西是要有点物质基础的，如果说我们之前没有任何组织的话其实也很难，哦，但是还好我们在2006年的时候我们就有一群人成立一个纪录片工会，哦，工人的工不是公司的工，哦，Union，哎，那就是基本上就是只要跟纪录片相关的工作者都可以加入，哦，那也因为有一个这样的组织，所以大家已经有一些小的 case， 有一些合作，然后有一些共识的基础，哦，所以这次就是在324那时候决定要开始做记录的时候，是以纪录片工会做一个基地，然后号召大家，哦，尤其是一些会员，哦，或者说里面的干部一起来开始合作，哦，然后大概是到就很快的，就是决定说，哎，如果我们要开始做影像素材的收集的话，那我们也许要去 要去决定一些主题，因为总不能说一群人大家都拍一样的东西，所以 要分出一些主题。那其实大家看到目前的主题有九个，其实在我们刚开始讨论的时候是有十二个主题，那目前没有拍到的，譬如说纠察线，我们觉得纠察线是一个有趣的东西，有人很讨厌纠察线，有人觉得纠察线很重要，那有人就说其实这个题目后来就虽然当时有讨论到，可是后来就没有做，那没有做有一些原因，等一下再说。
Well, as you know, most filmmakers or documentary makers, they work all by themselves. They are their own masters. So generally speaking, the working pattern is you do your own project. However, because first of all, because the Sunflower Movement is very influential and very affected quite a lot of people, including filmmakers. And they felt, after discussion, they felt they should have take the initiative and work together. So that's how they did it. Following the example, us the student inside the parliament, actually they student work together, and they also think it's a good idea to work together for a common cause. So the good news for them was, because in 2006, they already had some sort of kind, I said documentary union. It's, as long as you're a union member, as long as you're a documentary filmmaker, you can actually join the union. And they had, before this incident, actually they had some small project sometimes, they worked together. So they had this experience of working together and cooperate and contribute. So the union became the base for this film. So they become the core members, but they also call for contributions among the filmmakers. So they had a meeting and they decided various themes. Actually, they were 12 themes. However, certain themes were eventually didn't turn out to be included in this film, and he will talk about it later.
反正就是说有一些团体或者说有一些面向，因为我们合作的导演里面有的人就是他可能时间上他没办法就是配合。就是所以有的题目就是虽然有做变小了，譬如说野百合跟太阳花的对比，在这个片里面其实只有五分钟，可是当时的规划其实希望更长的，不过就是我负责的导演蔡静茹，他当时他这个过程里面他刚好都在日本做另外一部片子，所以他就没办法完全投入。然后譬如说有些团体，譬如工头们很重要，我们这片子播出来没有多久，就有工头们的朋友在抱怨说他怎么都没有谈到公投们，然后要故意把它切割掉这样。可其实并不是那样，而是其实本来李慧仁导演那个主题里面有谈到公投们，甚至他本来的片名叫做《切割与收割》。大家可以听到这个片名蛮刺激的，就说好像就是公投们在这个过程里面被这个运动切割掉了。可是其实就是说我们那在片子真的出来前有找一些。NGO 或者学院团体人一起来看，做一个内部试片，他们就大家有得到一个共识，就是说，其实工头们在这个运动里面的角色也很重要，没有错。可是我们可能要把它独立变成一个主题，没办法就是放在切割里面去谈，因为这样很可能会有点简化说，工头们这是被运动排除在外面。可是其实工头们本来就跟民主阵线的 NGO 团体本来就没有在一起合作。所以就是就变成说在真的整个运动里面他们是比较会在外围的，就好像不能纯粹用切割收割来看待这件事情。因为我们做这个片子有一个还蛮重要的点，就是说是希望促成对话，就像我刚刚跟大家讲的，而不是说在讲说谁切割谁做了一些收割这样子，因为这样可能只是会把原来有一些因为误会或者说因为一些过程的问题造成的误解或伤痕更扩大，我们不希望就是带来这样的副作用。所以像工头们这个主题，其实像李慧仁导演就觉得说 是他是希望说有机会他要另外独立来做这个题目，而不是说这个东西不重要。哦，这一先解释一下。
There are many organizations and dimensions they want to cover, and that, however, sometimes it's because the topic's a bit special, sometimes because the director's schedule can't really fit in very well with this their production. For example, the contrast between two student movements between the 1980s and 2014, there were only five minutes long. However, he said originally it was much longer and more important, just because the director had at that time she had to be in Japan, so eventually it just turned out to be a much shorter film. And also, there was a topic on, I hope I translated rightly, is a referendum alliance, a Gong Tou Meng. And that particular organization was quite important and was included in one of the film. However, it's called Chiege, you know, severing and harvesting. Okay, so Chiege Yu Shou Ge. However, it feels like this particular important organization was sort of marginalized, and it is not intentional. And also, the director wanted to make that particular organization maybe take all the material out and make it into an individual film rather than just fit in a short film into this particular one. And they said during the trial, and some NGO members were invited to look at this film, and they were saying, well, although Referendum Alliance is an important acting agent in this movement, however, they didn't really work with Democratic Alliance, 民主阵线.
Yeah, People's Democratic.
Front. And so the reason, because of this, it is quite important to have a focus. Eventually, they said they don't want to simplify this particular organization's contribution either. So it is only fair to make a individual film about it rather than just fit in, willy-nilly in a small section. So of course they also want to avoid any side effect of misunderstanding during the negotiation between students. So they really don't want to simplify this topic. So sometimes certain things being taken out just because not to create certain kind of misunderstanding.
反正简单讲就是说，因为时间跟篇幅的限制，所以有一些主题就。后来没有做，或者就是把它缩小了，那然后还有就是说，我们一开始就决定说，这个片子大概最多就是两个小时，因为一方面考虑到说，除非是剧情片，超过两个小时的片子，大概大家看起来是蛮辛苦的，就是这个是我们做纪录片的，怎么讲？我们算是比较自爱，我们不会想说。就是好像越长越好这样，因为其实如果就我们这几个主题来讲，我没有每个导演都有能力把它做很长。譬如说我是做国家机器的启动嘛，我本来版本是30分钟，那可是现在我们里面现在每个主题最长都被卡到只剩15分钟，就是希望控制在一定的长度。那还有一个更现实的原因是，因为未来因为想要做 DVD 回馈给赞助的朋友嘛。那其实如果超过两个小时的话，那个成本就会提高很多。那我们想要帮赞助者省钱，这个是另外一个经济的因素。因为我等一下会讲说赞助的部分是怎么样。反正就是说这两个小时，一方面考虑到大家看的那个能力，还有一个就是经济的考虑。所以整个制作时程其实是。决定两个小时以后，整个制作时程，还是先讲这样好。
OK, sorry. Because the consideration of time and the capacity of each director. So sometimes certain themes you can't, you have to sort of sacrifice. Sometimes you have to shrink them. For example, like his own film, that's the operation of state apparatus.
State apparatus.
Yeah. He was saying originally his own version is 30 minutes, but I think it has to be shrink to how long?
15
minutes. Okay. So that's the longest one. It doesn't mean that the longer the better. And even for us, a normal audience, even watching a feature film for 2 hours is quite a hard work. If longer than 2 hours is really hard work. So the reason why it's being cut and shrink into within 2 hours was because, first of all, it's the audience acceptability. It is otherwise longer than this you have to go to toilet, and no, that's why I am sorry. And another consideration is economic reasons. Of course, they want to save some money for the funders, and any DVD, because they want to sell the DVD, any DVD longer than 2 hours, the cost will be much higher. So in order to sell it and save some cost for making the DVD and distribute it, they decided to cut it within 119 minutes and a bit.
这个主题决定之后开始制作的时候，当然我们马上就想到说，那如果我们开始拍摄制作，那最后就说我们要做成一个成品的话怎么办？你总要有经费嘛，哦，然后那时候就有人提议说，透过那个募款平台，就是台湾一个Brand V，就是像美国那个 Kickstarter 那样的募资平台，然后他们当时就说，我们他本来叫 Plan V， 可是其实我们那个募款的信息是放在那个 V Democracy， 其实也是 Plan V 成立的，因为好像说当时政府找麻烦，不让他们在 Plan V 上面做这样的一个纪录片的募款，所以他们就马上成立一个 V Democracy。然后我们在 VT 方局，VT 方局那边办的。然后原来设定的目标是大概希望有200多万，至少可以把片子做出来。那可是没想到，就是我们哦对，然后那个企划案是我跟基本上是我企划案是我写的啦。我大概就是也在一两天内赶快把那个企划赶出来，然后再配合一些 VT 方局的工人找了一些图片，然后其实我们那时候连那个片花都来不及剪。就找了一个
片花，
片花就是类似 promo 那种东西。
Trailer，sorry，
就利用网络上一个现成的 trailer， 就是把一个现成的东西，然后变成一个我们的 trailer， 然后就是设定一个月募款，然后200万这样，可是没想到在两天就募到200多万，然后我们自己就是说。因为那时候是算是运动后期，还没有怎么结束，我们自己也吓了一跳，发现说，其实大家还蛮希望说有对碳化运动的一个影像记录，我们感受到那种大家的那种期待，那所以我们后来就没有设定说一定要募到多少钱，我们就是让他一个月跑完那样子，不然其实我们如果趁那个机会再把那个募款额度提高一点，也许会更多，所以我们后来就决定说。200万到了以后，我们就是开放，然后就是跟大家讲说要，就是让募款者决定，就是说你们要捐多少都可以。所以满一个月的时候，就大概500万左右，然后这样的金额就是，当然就是对我们来讲是超过我们的期待，本来是想说把片子可以做出来就好了，那因为后来募到比较多，我们就决定把这笔钱大概一半是做制作，一半做应援的巡回推广这样。所以就是一直到现在应该是说14号前两天之前，我们几乎就是
从那时候决定制作、哦、然后一直 到前两天才完成那个全台湾的一个巡回这样、哎、那我们这一场可以算是海外第一场公播的，对、哎、所以我觉得很开心。
Right. After the decision was made about which topic they are going for, and they were thinking, where can we get the money from? So I hope I get this right. They were saying they go for something called V-democracy. Some sort of
crowdfunding.
Okay, and it's a kind of platform for people put the proposal out then and get some sort of public funding. And the target was over 2 million NT dollars, not. and their target is to get $2 million within a month. And so Director Tsai, within a few days, he wrote a proposal and put together some sort of very limited trailers. At that time, the movement was still ongoing, so it's not like it's all drawn to a conclusion. So they were saying, okay, let's see whether we can get to million. But within 2 days, they hit the target. So that's really quite, you can see how passionate people felt about this. And then they said, okay, let's open this whole funding business for a month to see how it goes. And it's up to you how much you want to donate. Okay, then, fund. And within a month, they actually got over 5 million. That's definitely double their expectation. So half was put it towards production, and half actually they put into touring Taiwan. So I think most of the places are in universities. 巡回是在大学吗？
戏院。
Oh, sorry. Cinemas around the island. And until 4 days ago, 14th, they just finished the whole touring schedule. So this, you guys so lucky, this is the first overseas European, I think it's world premiere.
We better take
one more
question.
Okay.
Yeah.
Again.
Just
好，首先谢谢蔡导演为我们带来这部纪录片。我居然蔡导演带来的部分是国家机器的启动。那我就想要问的是，导演在这过程当中跟警察接触的经验，包括接洽，还有跟他们实地访谈的过程。然后以及你经历了这之后，你有什么样的反思？谢谢。
Should we take? Can we take the other one? The second question. There was one at the back as well. Yeah.
就是 before you ask the question, let me just translate this for the audience.
Okay.
This gentleman here was asking Director Tsai because he's in charge of, his film is the raid of a state apparatus, and he asked what's his experience of negotiating and contacting and interviewing the police, and what's his thought on this particular issue.
Okay.
因为您刚刚有提到，就是说他在当天之前已经完成全台巡回了嘛？就是我知道他的第一场好像是在济南路上举办的。那我想要了解一下，就是我有看到一些消息，就是当初就是好像林非凡他看完之后就哭了。我是想要了解，就是其实我刚看我也觉得很厉害了，所以我想要了解，就是运动过后。那时候的那些 Q&A， 就是当时参与的那些人，他们有没有就是对于未来的一些台湾的一个社会运动，他们有没有什么样，或者是看完就会有什么样的反思，或者是有要就是更多的期待这样子？
Okay, just quick translation. And she was saying the first Taiwan screening was an outdoor one, outside of the parliament, actually, on the street of Jinan Lu. And then she said, she read about the news that Lin Feifan, the leader or the president, Lin Feifan cried after seeing the film. And she would, her question was, what did anyone among the audience say anything as a movement participants or the occupier? Did they say anything, or how's your thought on this as well? Okay, 第一个警察。
先回答第二个问题好了，因为可能那个问题比较。 简单。Second question first。在济南路首映的那一场是我们很早就计划想要在那个运动现场播，因为我们觉得那有很大的意义这样子。然后那一天播的情况就是，现场来的观众很多了，哦，然后我们有调查一下，大部分都是有参加运动的人回来这样，哎，然后其实片子播完之后呢，就是像刚在跑字幕的时候啊，哎，那个字幕大概有两三分钟吧，那个掌声是没有停的，哦，然后我自己那时候是坐在前面第一排，哎，我就看就是好像跑到每个导演的那个 roll call 的时候，就大家都在鼓掌，好像那个导演就在那边一样，哎，反正我那时候的感觉是。自己还蛮感动的，就是说现场的人会哭，那我们坐在那个黑暗的第一排，我们其实也在流眼泪，就感觉好像就是，就是觉得说自己好像片子没有做得很好，可是好像大家都还是很鼓励这样，那个感觉，那是我第一次做纪录片有这种感觉，所以我觉得做太阳花运动的纪录片好像还是比较。比较会被鼓励，然后我们做其他社会议题啊，比较不会。啊，我顺便抱怨一下，我昨天在 Siri 放那个《邮政与毒共存》啊，哦，那是台湾一个很重要没看过重视事件的纪录片，在场的人大概只有你们这边的十分之一吧，这边有200多人，昨天就有20多个啦，所以我就是顺便抱怨一下，说一样是社会议题，好像对大家那个热情的程度差很多。
这个跟主题
地点的问题啊，
地点，对他没有安慰说是地点的问题，
对，
不过还是很开心，今天有那么多人来，
开心。The Taiwan Premier outside of the Parliament, it was very meaningful for us. We decided that location exactly because it was where it happened.Where this movement took place. Of course, there are loads of audience, you know, but he can tell that quite a lot of the people among the audience were actually who took part in the movement, or either inside or outside the parliament. And especially at the end of the credit scene, the applause didn't stop, you know, continuously for 2-3 minutes.But you guys did stop.
我没有说。
He didn't say that. He didn't say that.
He didn't say that. I said it. But he said when he was sitting in the dark, he felt very moved, and of course everyone's teary, and he felt really encouraging. No, he felt encouraged and supported.By the support among the audience, because he said, although our, well, he's being honest, no, humble, sorry. He said he felt that the films were not that great, not excellent. However, you know, I got really high support in comparison to other social issues. He noticed that sometimes not everyone's very supportive or.Even concerned about social issues. For example, the films that he showed in Surrey, and it's not a popular issue. Sometimes we should really also take care or you know, concern.
Well, they can always go and watch his film tomorrow night.
Yes, you show your support and go to Surrey.
I know it's too far.
No, no, it's not actually not far. So, what time?
7:30. Yeah.
7:30, and check out their website. Okay. And the first question about the police.
No, no, 我还没有结束第一个。
Oh, sorry.
我刚讲的是我的反应。
Oh.
我要讲的是观众的反应。我觉得有两种很有趣，是第一种反应是，譬如说里面在播我那个主题，就是警察就是像那个保总队总队长在讲话的时候，哦，然后坐在我后面那一排的那个观众啊，他就一直在骂三字经，好像那个警察就在他对面一样，他就对他讲的话很不满，对不对？那然后当然就是还有的反应就是觉得说，是不只是现场啦，其实我们那一天很可惜是因为时间的关系，并没有真的 Q&A。我们比较就是结束以后大家在聊天的，那还有就是我们比较有跟观众互动，是我们那个全岛巡回的时候，譬如我是负责台南跟嘉义的，那结束以后就是有观众会问一些问题，那基本上大部分的观众都还蛮肯定我们做这样的努力，虽然他们知道说我们因为一些局限，片子没有那么，就是东西没有那么完整，没有那么深入，大家都是还蛮包含的，然后有的人就是会。有人提的一些问题是我没有想到，比如说他们觉得《岛屿天光》这个主题，这个音乐很好，为什么不把它当主题曲？为什么片子里面没有听到《岛屿天光》这样子？然后或者他会讲说，有些画面他觉得很不错，怎么？在学音的过程里面，他有看到一些画面，就譬如说他举着手机在那边，那个在那边咬的那个一些很壮观的话，为什么没有用进去？
没有用在哪里？
就是没有用在那个片里面，就是没有变成主要画面这样子。就是有人对音乐、对画面会有一些想法这样子，然后有的人当然就觉得说，因为我们也蛮想要知道说，这个运动结束以后，他们大家到底在做什么，有没有受到什么样的影响？那有的人就会说，他们其实现在台湾有在发起要回家去投票嘛，有的人就是投入这样的运动啊，那我觉得这个东西都是很具体的，就是我们一直有在讲，我们一直有一个感觉，就是说这个运动，就是说不会因为我们做个记录，就好像有一个结论嘛。所以我们基本上我们这个纪录片是一个 open ending， 就好像这个运动其实还在，这个运动的精神其实也还没有死掉，它还在很多不同的领域里面正在发酵这样子。我自己从观众里面得到一些回馈，就有这种感觉。
He at first said there are two reactions. I only heard one, sorry. Especially there's during the scene that the police was explaining they were really taking great care of dealing with the students. And the audience behind him, he said he could hear them talk back swearing, as if it's talking back to the police head or a chief, and quite rudely. And of course, it's quite different from the situation format here. There was no Q&A during the first premiere outside the parliament, but people did stay back and chat to each other. However, taking the film around the island, and he's in charge of the southern part of Taiwan's touring. And he said most of the reaction was very positive, everyone's very encouraging, and even though the film is not giving you a complete, they can't promise you a complete conclusion or a picture of that, but at least they try to give you different angles and different way of looking at things. And sometimes people ask questions that they never thought about. For example, people say, why didn't you use the light of island or something?
Island sunrise.
Ooh, island sunrise. Sorry about popular culture. And 岛屿天光, why didn't you use it as a theme music? You know, why didn't you? Because it's such a beautiful and fitting music. They say, oh, we never thought about that. Or there's a particular a scene that people holding up their mobile phone, switch on the torch and waving, to replace maybe candle light or something. That scene is very quite beautiful in the dark. And why didn't they put more focus on this kind of emotional thing? But they say, you know, sometimes you can't take everything. And he said, sometimes he's thinking, what do these kids do now after the movement? And he was saying, for example, recently in Taiwan, there's a campaigns called Go Home and Vote, okay? 回家投票 is a practical and realistic way of taking part in politics. And for them, this film is a provide you an open ending, so you draw your own conclusion. But the most important thing is the spirit of Sunflower Movement never dies. They will live with everyone who's taking part or concerned about it. That's it.
I think we've almost run out of time, actually.
And how about the first question?
We'll have to answer that one, then we need to take the group picture.
Otherwise, we'll
and
be
And we've got a reception as well upstairs.
Okay.
那还有一个同学第一个问题没有。我讲快一点哈。好。那个国家企业启动这个片子，其实如果我要简单一点做的话，其实我就是访问那些被警察打的人，然后骂国家机器、骂警察就好了，对不对？那这片子很麻烦的，还去找到行政院发言人跟那个警察。哦，那是因为我自己做一个纪录片的习惯是说。 就算你是比较批判观点的话，你也必须你的批判也要有根据，然后你要有证据，哦，然后你最好是能够两面并陈，哦，而不是只是单面传播，哎，那所以就是我就设法去找到当时保护总队的总队长，因为他也在学校教书，哦，我就把他，我就设法找到他联络方式，然后称呼他黄老师，哦，对，就是好像把他变成我的同行这样，哎，然后。 然后我就跟他说，我很希望我们太阳花运动的纪录片里面也有官方的说法，不要只是学生这边在骂政府，哦，因为我一直会觉得说，除非我们是要做给自己爽的，我们自己看好玩的，不然的话你就最好要有不同面向的说法，然后让观众去做判断，因为我期待我们的片子不是只有太阳花运动人看，最好中间立场也会看，对不对？所以要撑出这个可以互相辩证的空间很重要。 然后那个黄老师，那个黄总队长就说，他其实很担心我们这个片子会变成一个一面倒的片子，哦，他就很容易变一面倒。哦，我就跟他说，对，我就是不希望他一面倒，所以你们一定要出来讲话。哎，那他可能也有点被我说服了，所以后来就是他本来就是没有说一定要被访问，可是后来他同意了，而且不止他出来被访问，他把他的里面的主管都找出来。 哦，然后还有就是行政院发言人那边是我自己本来又另外联络，哦，我是两边并行嘛，哦，那结果后来就是发现约访之后，他们全部都来了，就在行政院那边一起访问的，哦，他们自己轮流上来被我访问的，就你们看那个场景是一样的，哎，啊，可是就是说，那个总队长他会对自己，他会觉得好像发言人还有他的下面的组长都讲得不够好。 他自己访问完以后，他有跟我讲说，尽量用他讲的话，因为其他人就是他觉得比较没有讲那么清楚，好，我就跟他说，好，那我就尽量用你讲的话，所以你会看到片里面就是比较都是那个总队长讲的话，可是有的人看的感觉是说他讲话好像对警察没有帮助，那可是我觉得没关系，让观众自己去做判断嘛，就至少我做到应该要有两面并陈的一个努力了。
Okay. To put things simply, he could just interview all the victims who have been beaten up. But for him, the most important thing, if you want to be critical, you really should give two sides the equal chance to express themselves, to be balanced, like BBC. And of course, sorry. And in the film, that one of the especially there's a very heavy focus on the chief captain 黄什么？
黄宗仁。
黄宗仁 ，anyway， and he said to convince him, he had to tell him that first of all, call him 黄老师。Teacher Huang, as if that they are, because Director Tsai is also an academic, so as if you're talking to your colleagues. And he was saying that he wants to have an official side of the story, so this film will be less balanced, biased. And and he wanted to provide all the official side of the police side of the principal and the story. They said, okay, not only I want to be interviewed, I also want my staff to be interviewed, and also the speaker from the executive yuan also was interviewed. However, after everyone's been interviewed, he said to Director Tsai, I think they are not very articulate. I want you to use mostly my speech. And he said, oh, all right then, because it didn't help. So, that's it.
Okay, I think let's give Director Tsai one more round of applause.